Hey friends, Magic Brad here with Synergy Cafe and the Synergy Collaborative, and I got my friend Dr. Derek on again, and we're going to talk about some programs he's got. You there, Derek, and can you hear me?
I am here, and I can hear you loud and clear.
Perfect. I'll make sure my sound thing is all up, and it is. Okay, we should have a good transference of energy here.
Perfect.
So tell us a little bit about who you are, where you are, what you do, and then we'll get into this program that you're supporting.
Yeah. As you introduced me, I'm Dr. Derek Anderson. I own HealthSource Chiropractic of Minnetonka, down in the Glen Lake area of Minnetonka, right off of Excelsior Boulevard, next to the Gold Nugget Restaurant.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. Well, a lot of people are probably somewhat familiar with chiropractic these days because it's gotten popular. I remember back in like the 90s, there was a friend of mine that was just getting into it, and I thought, what's chiropractic? Can't you just crack your... But there's a lot to it, and I go to a chiropractor once in a while. My wife loves it. She goes often. And there is those things that happen, and I'll use my layman's terminology of what I believe it is the muscles start getting tense, and they start moving the bones around, and it ends up being sort of a compounding thing because now the bones are in a different direction, so the nerves start doing things that make the muscles even more contracted, and that's why a lot of people end up getting stressed out and hunched over and all that. They just got to relax a little bit, right?
Yeah, exactly. I mean, it's kind of with people, it's kind of the chicken or the egg thing. Which came first? Did the spinal column move out of alignment due to some sort of trauma or stress or just poor posture through an increased amount of time? And that's what caused the nerve to be compressed, and then the muscles get tight, and then they get more stressed, and that. Or is it because through time their muscles get tighter, and they start to pull the spine out of alignment, which makes things become worse? And that, I mean, and it is, with some people it's in column A, with some people it's column B. So it really does, change from person to person.
I think that before we got into all this internet technology, and we moved away from where there's actual labor going on in the world, where people had to work, they sort of got some exercise and they moved their spine and stuff around and they moved their joints and they could kind of get back into alignment. But nowadays we just kind of sit.
Yes.
And
I always tell patients all the time, movement is life, and the moment that you stop moving is the moment that your body starts to degenerate and starts to decay. I mean, it's crazy some of the research that's out there that shows. And even back, like you said, back in the 90s and even early 2000s, when someone would sprain an ankle or they'd throw out their back or whatever it was, the recommendations from the doctors were always just like, oh, rest. You have to lay down, let the joints rest, let the muscle rest. It's like, and now as they've done more and more research on the healing process in the body, they're going, no, move. You need to move as much as you possibly can. And and I remember talking to some chiropractors back when I was shadowing and starting to figure out that I wanted to be in this profession. I talked to people who have been treating since the 80s and the 90s, and they would tell me all the time, like, their practice has shifted from being 80% low back pain, and 20% neck, headache, other things, to now it's about a 50-50 split because people are starting to sit at desks all the time and use computers and technology, and a lot of more of the issues are starting to come within their neck and their upper back and causing different ailments.
Well, that what I was just thinking about, that's a good segue into the program you were talking about, because what ends up happening, I think, is people get they start using artificial painkiller kind of stuff.
Yep.
And then because your body, when you get, say you sprain an ankle, your body knows not to put pressure on it. You go, oh, that kind of hurts.
Yep.
So your body's telling you to do that. And as soon as you put a painkiller on there, like this happened when I was in high school gymnastics, and you'd tear a muscle. So you'd put all that cream and stuff on there and it numbs it up.
Yep.
Well, now you don't care. And you just do what you got to do, and it tears it even more.
Yes.
So you've got a program that you're working on that sort of helps people kind of wean them off of them. Painkillers are good when someone's in extreme pain, but you can get reliant on them.
Yes. There's a time and place for pain medication and painkillers, especially the harder stuff like the OxyContin, the oxycodone, hydrocodone, Vicodin, like all that stuff. There's definitely a time and place for it, but the problem with that is the key ingredient in all those are what are called opioids, and there's a huge, huge epidemic going on, not only in our country, but the world, in the overuse and the addiction that people get from starting with those.
And it's just that magic pill that someone can take. Now the pain is magically gone, but the damage is not.
Yes, exactly. And you're exactly right. The thing that happens is those opioids and stuff, they trigger onto your nerve receptors, basically just masking your pain and your symptoms. And you start to utilize that, and then you can get back to doing what you're doing because your body is basically numb to that sort of pain, but it's not fixing the underlying issue, and you can make things worse. And that's when, you know, people become addicted to that. We just did a regional summit this past weekend, and we had a speaker who came in and talked, and I think one of the biggest stats he was talking to me about or talking to us about was the fact that he said like 80% of all heroin users or addicts actually started from an addiction to painkillers or opioids in that point. And it leads to that, you know, that addiction that just keeps feeding itself, and you need a bigger dosage or you need more to kind of get that, sure, that high and that rush. And
yeah, I can see that happening. It's sort of a gateway drug to drugs because yes. You end up, God, I feel a lot better. My back doesn't hurt. Now I can feel even number. And then you'd start using it recreationally, and it just goes downhill from there. So,
exactly.
So you got a program that you're working with an organization, and could you share a little bit about that? And then I'm going to close this one up because I don't like to take too much of people's time because time is a commodity we can't get back. So I do these real short like this just to let people know who you are, what you do, and how you can help.
For sure. So yeah, it's really cool. The Health Source has teamed up with the Salvation Army. And one specific branch of that Salvation Army is the Opioid Addiction Foundation. And so they're trying to get people off of opioids and mostly trying to get people not to even start taking opioids in the first place. And so obviously as chiropractors, that's what we're about. We're about natural medicine. We're about healing the body from within, not taking pills to artificially fix just symptoms that people have. So what we're doing is any patient from now until the end of November that calls us up and wants us to take a look at something that they've been dealing with, some symptom, low back pain, neck pain, headaches, whichever it is, their initial visit into our office is only $20. And that includes a consultation, a full examination, and then any x-rays that they might need for us to take a look at. All that's just $20. And the $20 that we get, that gets coded a certain way in our office, and all of that $20 goes to the Salvation Army and their cause to help fight opioid addiction within our country.
Oh, cool. That's almost like a viral loop kind of thing. It kind of loops back and
pay it. It's a cool thing, and it's not only helping people, because the people that come in here are going to be helped, and they're not going to have to go get surgery, or they're not going to have to go and take painkillers to help fight their pain. But at the same point in time, we're trying to give money to a foundation that's obviously dear to us as chiropractors and helping to get people away from fighting that addiction.
Well, perfect. Well, that's enough. I'm going to look up some of that stuff on the internet. And if you have any links you want to send to me specifically, cool. I will put them in this video as I put it up and propagate it out to the universe in a collaborative effort, because that's what the Synergy Collaborative is all about. So thanks, Dr. Derek. You get back to work helping people, and I'm going to do some marketing and promotion for you.
Thank you very much, sir. I appreciate the time.
Peace. Thanks.
All right. Bye.